Time for another episode of Antique Quest and a Harrison Sons Auctions video walkthrough. Thanks for watching, folks. Hi, welcome to our channel. Antique Quest is our channel, and this is for our Harrison Sons winter antique sale walkthrough. So what we're going to do today is just walk you around, show you some of the things that are online right now on harrisonsonsauctions.com, which leads you to a link to HiBid, and you can bid on our auctions and any of these items that we're going to show you here today. So this particular one is probably my favorite in the auction, and it's very seldom that you're going to find a toy of this caliber in this kind of condition, which crosses folk art and toys absolutely fabulously. It's a pull-along toy, all carved and painted out of wood. Like I say, there's detailed pictures online. It has this little built-in stand, which brings the wheels off the ground, which I think is just so you can see what it does. Now, some of the things need a bit of work, but it has this fabulous band of monkey acrobats. You see how this main character here bends over and bows and tips his hat to everybody. And the other ones go around and around and do their thing. And just a wonderful thing. Now the dog, who was working before, I'll have to check, he is supposed to run around and around and around like this, with all his legs as well. But when you pull it along, it does all these wonderful things. There he goes, he's starting to go. So it just needs a little bit of work underneath. There's little levers and whatnot. And this one is just sort of a hand operated. Oh no, he goes down there too, but he doesn't seem to be hooked up. He's a little stiff. I think the wood's just swollen a little bit here. But let me see if I can get him to do anything here. Yeah, see, he will do same as the others, but his bar here is sort of caught up. So you could get to working on that. But the paint is fantastic. The characters are great. I love this fellow with his tipping his hat and bowing to the audience. And you just slide that up. But a fantastic piece of folk art there. Nice old clock. You know, I think it's probably the best time there is to buy clocks right now. We used to sell a lot of these back when I had my store in Hamilton on Lock Street. I sold a lot of mantle clocks, bracket clocks, that sort of thing. And a clock like this would typically bring $400 without any trouble at all. This one, the opening bid is $75. It is in running condition. It's a nice bracket style with the little brass spandrels in the corner. Very nice clock. Probably the best time to get a clock. I think every house ought to have an old clock. It just doesn't seem right without one. But now we have, you know, stoves and everything else tell us the time. But in the day, that was a very important mechanism for the house, so they had an idea of what time it was. So let's show you some more things, and we'll see what we have for you.
First off, we'll just show you a couple of these nice carpets that we have in this sale. And a nice long runner up ahead. These are hand knotted. And keep your eye open for our next antique auction, where we have quite a few carpets coming in.
Now we do have some great local stoneware in this auction, and some just some rare pieces. Got this great little Halifax five line merchant crock in really good shape, nice little ears on it, great little piece there. We have this C.P. Shaw from Windsor, Nova Scotia, nice jug there. In good shape, a little chip there, not a big deal. A little bit of scaling off the glaze here, but all in all, a decent jug in good shape. Got the set of three ginger beers, Sussex, Halifax, and a green topped Gourds. They're all one lot in the sale. Got this T. Anthony & Sons Berwick, Nova Scotia. Now that is a very rare to find any crocks with a Berwick name on it. Again, you have glaze scaling all over here. I'm going to move my pretty wild looking folk art lady here. She'll just stand in that one. Just to give you an idea, there is a chip here in one of the ears, but no serious cracking. lots of glazed scaling. But again, it's the name you're looking for on a merchant crock like this, especially with the Berwick on there. T. Anthony Sons. Nice little rabbit. This is made in occupied Japan, and boy, do they know how to fit them in the box. But he's just as new. Wind him up and he hops along. Great little occupied Japan early wind-up toy. So I can't get back in there because it's not much of a box. There we go. And we also have Jas Baird, St. John's, Newfoundland. So hard to find Newfoundland jugs. 3 gallon in absolutely great condition here. No chips, no cracks. I think there's one on the base. Has this little foot stuck to the bottom, and it looks like it had 4 at one time. But really, no damage at all. And lastly, we have this Sullivan and Company, St. John's, New Brunswick. St. John, New Brunswick. Again, really great condition. You know, these are big jugs, 3 gallon jugs. Got little feet there just to protect it. No chips, no cracks, no breaks. So a great condition for a little merchant jug there. And while we're here, we have some painted folk art shells, some sconces down in the bottom, a few books, an interesting early Massachusetts, if I remember correctly, Plymouth, Massachusetts, yeah. Photographer's painted piece, so would have started as a photograph, I'm assuming. There's his early label on the back, and then painted over top. Nice little portrait. And this double stacking barrister's bookcase, which of course is pickup only, but we arrange that no problem. So, great old fan. Now this one does plug in, it does run, it's silent, nice smooth. I did get a bit of an electrical burn smell with it. Probably hasn't been running a long time, but it had no issues running at all. And this nice, really nice nip-on lamp. Needs to be rewired and redone. There's absolutely nothing wrong with the body of the lamp at all. It has been loaded with what sounds like glass beads or marbles, something along that line. So we're putting that as pickup only because shipping it will just shatter it unless we were to take it all apart, which I really don't want to get into. Let's see what else we have. All right, I'll see if I can show you some of this. We've got these nice lidded Nova Scotia redware crocks. Again, in good condition. Hard to find with the lids, of course. Some of the lids we have chipping, but again, all these condition reports will be on the website. Some interesting crook knives. Nice early one there. Beautiful handle on this one, all bird's eye maple. Just fits in your hand perfectly. And these we don't get as often, but this is a big Newfoundland one with an antler handle. Nice little curve on the handle there. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. And a little hooked blade, which looks like it was like a farrier's tool at one time. But this piece here, it does not photograph well. It's very hard to show you how fabulous this piece is. This is an early Quebec riding crop. And the leather has the absolute perfect wear on it. It's all chip carved. The entire handle all the way around is chip carved. It's absolutely gorgeous. But the leather work here, and I know it is not going to show it, but the wrap has these little squares set into it in different places all the way along. It's absolutely beautifully wrapped handle there. Just a rare, neat, early piece. Got a great Nova Scotia document box in paint, found in the valley, Annapolis Valley piece, lot 417, and painted on all 4 sides, all dovetailed with the leather strap handle. Can never have enough boxes. A swordfish bill for any of you guys that want to make it into a sword. It was common to do at one time, but just a neat piece. It would be interesting to carve, I would think. But a good size swordfish bill there, old one. And that ships inside the country only.
And this is actually Bose Canada, even though it looks like a nice early splatterware jug. But it's a later one, but it's in absolutely perfect condition. It's a beautiful jug. Really nice piece. We have a lot with two different pantry boxes, small one and a larger one. And we have a very early gin bottle. A lot of people have seen these, but this one's almost black, but it has a fabulous applied lip there. This one would date 1790 to 1820, so one of the earliest ones we've had. A great little Paris painting that has quite a bit written on the back that I can't quite make out. We did find a street in Paris that's written on here, but I can't quite make out if that signature is the same as this name. So we have that all written down there for you to decide, but it's a neat little painting. Very nicely done. And a set of New Hampshire grain measures, but a nice set with the stamping, Wilton, USA, and Burn, or Berry, Bear, E. Berry. I don't know quite how you say that, Bear. That's a peck, and this one was, let me see, a half a bushel. This has the iron crisscross on the bottom. But it's nice to have them in paint with the owner's initials stenciled in there. So that's a pair. Great decorator pieces. Some wonderful big butter presses. Two of those in the sale. And this one's full of S's. So I don't know if they use that more for candy. They just wanted their initial of their company on there. Not quite sure why. Now, let's have a look at this, because this is a fabulous doll's print. Let's see if we can give us some space here. Alright, I'm just going to set that down for a minute. But the condition is what's all important here. It's absolutely fantastic. The stenciling is still beautiful. The wallpaper floor in this is still there. A beautiful tuft seat. And the Avon, I don't know if you can see this, but let's see. They've even decorated inside up underneath. Stencil painted underneath as well. The baby, the parent baby, would have something to look at. Nice iron bound wheels, original paint, everything's original. Even the tassels are still intact. The leatherette on the top, just a really neat piece. Great decorator piece. So we're just gonna move down the table and show you some more.
A couple of great signs in the sale, and this is a light up Du Maurier Jazz Festival sign.
I don't think you're going to see it very well, but to give you an idea of its size, it's all aluminum framed. It plugs in. It's got metal hangers on the top here. You know, it's fairly thick as well, but it has an extra outlet to plug other signs in. And same thing on the other side, but just a great sign with lights up. I love these characters. They're fantastic. Very deco-y looking jazz characters. And the other sign we have, I don't know if you can see it, but it's down there between the two tables, and that's a moose head one that would have been ordered for at a bar or restaurant and meant to hang on the wall, light up, and look like neon. Really great sign. Okay, got some nice West Coast totem poles here. This one's really neat. Alliford Bay in BC, but it's got nice wear on that one. Earlier piece, we have a walrus tusk. If any of you want to try doing some scrimshaw or making a handle, or it may have been a tool at one point that they put something in there and just used as a handle. Nice coffee grinder wall mount with all its accessories. A set of three,
jugs with the British Registry mark. Nice English graduated jugs. We have quite a few of these early Dalton pitchers. So I got to see if I'm in the picture or not here. Let's move him over for a minute. So these typical ale jugs, they'd call them, with just fabulous little attachments to the handle. We have quite a collection of those. And then you also have these that had the sterling silver rim on them as well. A little smaller size. And they get right down into some little ones. We actually have some miniatures that are only that tall too. Most of these are Dalton, but they did have some other makers. It's really interesting. Black Forest, German coat hook or hat hook. It has had a old repair to one of the horns, and I don't know how to pronounce the name of the deer type animal that has these. It's sort of a chamois. I'm not quite sure how to say that, but more common in Germany. And we have this magnificent Westerwald punch bowl. And the only flaw in the entire thing is a wee little tiny chip right there. But otherwise, this is in mint condition. And it's just a fantastic piece. This was brought over by the family from Germany. We have the largest pitter I've ever had in a sale. And this just works beautifully. And one thought was it might be for peaches, but I'm not sure you could fit a peach pit through there. But if it's a cherry pitter, it's the biggest one we've ever had. We've got some great early Annapolis Valley ox decoration here. Some pieces, nice early mortar. And then we get into these. This is a great big jug. We're assuming that's German as well. Came from the German family. Nice piece there. I should show you this one though. This is an early Staffordshire jug of Lord Nelson. It looks, because of the discoloring here, that it had an early repair on the inside here. Doesn't show up too much on the outside, but very early Staffordshire jug. And again, this is the other ale jug with the sterling rim, and that's in a lot together with two of the cups that are stamped with the sterling rims as well. A nice classic Toby jug. Some really nice pottery. Now this one's a bit of a mystery. This is a Japanese vase. I'm not 100% sure about this mark. Again, go online, see the pictures. I'll leave that up to the experts in Japanese porcelain, but nice vase there. This should give you a bit of a size comparison. So I'm 6'3 and a bit, so give you an idea. So we have this great folk art head carved out of an old fishing boy. Glass eyes, plastic teeth, looks like they might have cut an old margarine container or something like that. But it's an old folk art carved fishing float. Does not come with the stand, that's mine. Beautiful painting here, quite like this one actually, and there goes my nail, so it won't go back up again. Let's see if we can get a good picture of this. Really nicely done, really nicely painted, and it's signed by Mabel Anderson, 1966, Northwest Arm. Don't know a whole lot about her. I have found a listing for her. So she was listed with the Canadian Artists website. And we have a nice lamp here, and it's adjustable. Each piece, this block, will slide down this one, and the other one will slide and move, and you just adjust it. Norvel Morisseau card print. This, I think, is fantastic. This is an early poster, and this was for a show of Navajo turquoise that was for sale in Paris. I think it's absolutely fantastic piece. It's signed, numbered, but a really neat thing. I just love the graphics of it. Along with that, we have the tobaccoist countertop Indian in a chalkware. And I have seen him quite a few times. He was a common thing in old cigar stores. But this one I haven't seen very often. I don't know that I've ever seen it, tell you the truth. And it's just the same idea, but a wall plaque that would have hung on the wall. It's chalkware as well. A set of Vivian Nickerson oil paintings. Very
thick palette, but it's almost like a pointillism, but with a palette. So much bigger than dots that you'd see in pointillism, but together they kind of go together to make one big seascape. So, and a crowl, T crowl, oil on canvas there. And we have a beautiful decanter, and this is much earlier than it looks. It's a real rich, kind of a cranberry amethyst color, a ground off pontal scar on the bottom, but just a really nice early decanter there. The uranium glass tazzas, there's my nail, I just kicked it across the floor. And they are uranium glass. Fantastic Chinese pewter bound basalt teapot with its original lid in superb condition with the dragons all around. The nice thing about this is the eyes are decorated as well in the dragon. Little copper eyes, and has these little brass highlights as well. Just a really nicely made teapot. This gorgeous little box. I really can't pin it down where I think this is from. Could be French. I'm not sure. But I love the way they've done these serpentine sides. It's in a burled walnut. It's just like a little coffer. Just a really neat little box. We have some signed art glass pieces. This one's quite nice. Let's see if I can remember who this is signed by. This is the Chatham Glass Company. Really nice little vase there. Nice little Quebec aquatint etching. And I think that's it for, this dish. I don't think we're gonna see how good the quality is on this. I would say it's Japanese. It looks like a Japanese. It's a bronze. It's a frog on a leaf, and it shows a lot of tracing of the original gilt that would have been on it, still on the bottom side. But the detail in the leaf, the vines, and the, I mean, it's just beautifully, beautifully done. Much better than it might first appear in a photograph. Okay. And we have this big tureen that came from the DCS Montcalm. So it was on a ship, it had a hard life, but still really neat for any of you collectors of nautical or military ships. Let's see, maybe I'll show you some of these. Potsma, Nova Scotia, studio pottery, center bowl, great big thing. Beautiful piece in great shape. Which reminds me, actually, this really interesting jug here. Now, I'm told this is French, and it is signed. Go online, have a look at that. But just a great form. Love the handle on that one. Okay, we've got a nice early violin, some leg traps. We'll show you a few more. Another piece of art glass, and that one is signed, well, it has a stamp rather than not signed, Artistic Glass Blowing Studio. And that's in a lot with this signed piece of glassware. And that one, signed Nicholson, 1990. And some of the old retro stuff. We have this beautiful Lorraine glass made in Canada. Reminds me of a big pair of lips. Okay, and we've got some nifty retro here. This copper tray is really interesting. It's got a very unusual pattern on it. Very interesting the way they've attached the edge. It does have some really serious hack marks, so it's definitely craft made. But unfortunately, no one thought to sign it, because I think it's a really good piece. Really interesting pattern on there. All right, let me swing it down so you can see some of this stuff. All right, we've got bags of ivory chessmen, and we have mostly a set plus. So you can take pieces you might need to make up any that are missing a small little piece. These incredible glass ball feet. Look at the great gargoyle face on them, but look at the size of them. They're absolutely huge. And that's a set of four. The old refrigerator jars that you used to get for your juice, you know, because they didn't have containers like we have now. So, but nice to see them still in original condition. Some of the retro Asian ladies statues. Some interesting early lamps. This Holt Howard juice set is still in its original shipping box. So that's exactly how they used to ship these, with straw in between everything. And it's just always neat to find things in their original box. Great little carving of Benjamin Franklin. Well, I won't say carving because I'm not quite sure what it's made of. Has had a foot re-glued on here. The chair is definitely wood, but I'm not sure if he's like a plaster. But this was found originally under a glass dome. So really neat little model there if you're a fan of Benjamin. The cast iron wood stove with all its accessories. Now this was the bank that I had when I was a kid too. How to Get Wealthy by A. Miser. And you put your coin there and you trip the little lever and the hand would come scoop it. Really neat piece. We have a nice cookery. Interesting handle on this one with the ivory inlaid. Again, that keeps us from sending it outside of the country. Nice early leather sheath with that one. And lastly over here, I guess I have the Northern Electric telephone, where you just pull this off. Now these kind you'd typically see just in a little wooden box, you know, finger jointed oak box. But that's the important part right there. Okay, I'll show you the other wall and what we have. Okay, we have our other wall here. We have a set of botanical prints. And early, and according to the labels on the back, the certificate of authenticity says they're London 1797 by Andrews. So frame set there. This is interesting, the way they painted the mat. That's all hand painted. Nice little Nova Scotia piece here. Signed Joseph P. I don't think it's Joseph Purcell, but you never know. 1981. Real stipple effect, almost like a stucco look to it. We can show you. This is a really unusual painting. It is signed down here in the corner. You can see some, it looks like a little Volkswagen and that, covered in snow, and this couple fighting the storm. But what I find interesting is this photography label, and that's the same name that's on the front. So just kind of interesting. He tried his hand at painting, I guess. Another Dennis Teagle with the rowboat. Shady Glade in New Brunswick. Still not sure who that is. I'm sure somebody would know. We have a nice big lap desk down there as well. But I'm going to show you this painting. Now, this oil painting, again, came from Germany. Let me see if I can get it to where it'll focus on it. It's very dark. It's, you know, the varnish needs a clean. There is a little issue right here at the very top where it looks like it might have had a little kind of a repair. It's really well painted, but I find the back is probably as interesting as the front on this one. So very old canvas, no question about that. But what's interesting, it actually has a wax seal right here. Just nothing I can read. But the fact that it has a wax seal on the back, I find quite interesting. It has these huge iron brackets that have been on there a very long time, that are sort of holding the frame together, the old gesso and curved wood frame. But this is really neat too. It has this part of a label over here. There's not enough to go on, unfortunately, but there is something there. So this could really help with the research. The fact that it came over from Germany might help as well. But there's not enough of a word there for me, but what I do see looks like it's in German. But the frame, I mean, if this focuses, like, look at the age of this frame. You know, so between that and this little wax seal that's right at the top, don't think that's going to focus. And the fact that it's a really nicely done painting, could really be a sleeper in the auction, could really be a gem waiting to be figured out by somebody that knows and has the time to do it. All right, one more table, and I think we'll get into a few of the small things. Probably should do these videos at night so I'm not plagued by the light coming through the window. A little basket here I forgot to show you. Interesting, it's stenciled WM Black, which is really neat because we don't see a lot of these with names on them. So that's sort of a rarity. And we have this great lot for the Turo Fire Department. Anybody that collects firefighters, nice early helmet there. And we have, let me just find these in here. A couple of the Turo Fire Department badges go with that in that lot that we just have in the pocket of this fabulous fire department vest. And this also has a badge on it as well. And of course, all the fire department buttons on the vest. So that's a lot, a really great lot for anybody that collects firefighter memorabilia or Turo items. We've got some nice oil cans here. This Marvlube's in really nice shape, an earlier one. We have this Eureka harness oil with the interesting top. For all these tin collectors out there, we have a pair, and these have not been cleaned or anything. This is just how we found them. This one's almost mint. This one could use a cleaning. Little handy oils, Esso handy oils, a pair. There's a couple nice block and tackles. Great New Brunswick Mount Allison baseball photograph with everybody's name printed on the bottom. And these are the champions from 1915. So love to find these early sports photographs. A really neat, heavy old phone with the fire department's number on there. Great piece there. I wonder if you could rewire that. It'd be kind of neat. Now, we did get some interesting tools. This walking tape measure is really neat. The whole thing is solid brass or bronze. It might even be bronze. But what's really neat is all the distances are marked with solder. So you get 0, 1, 2. Everything's marked with solder. I've never seen that before. So obviously an earlier piece there. We have a nice lot with this little brass and oak level. These look great if you refinish them. And that comes with this brass little air pump. Whether that was for a bicycle or what, I'm not sure. And nice early plumb bob. Brass in its original leather holder. Here's a great CNN oiler. It's still a little dirty from its use, but you can clean that up and it'll look great. And it actually has the CNR embossed in the bottom, Canadian National Railways, for railroad collectors, as well as this Adlake lantern, railway lantern. This is a two-man chainsaw. Now, these were commonly military pieces, I'm told, and you just attach these wooden handles, they unscrew, into these ends, and two men work it. And it just wraps right around. You cut a pole in half. Really neat piece there. But this is fantastic. This, I was so excited to find this. It's an Arctic Cat helmet. But look at the groovy 70s colors, like metal flake green and purple. And it even still has the L for large that it would have had in the store. It is never used. It is absolutely old stock. Beautiful. Came with its original flyer, which is really neat too. I mean, it's a little rougher. It's had a little moisture attacked it over the years. And we actually still have the original box it came in. Now, this is where the moisture attacked the box, but we kept it in case anybody wants it. But the helmet itself is just fantastic.
We've got a lot down there of license plates. And again, for a snowmobile collector, we've got a bombardier toolkit that would have went for your snowmobile. And not sure if everything's in there, but that's exactly how it was found. Neat piece for snowmobile collectors. And what else do we have? This is a survey piece of equipment. I imagine that went into a tripod. It's got lots of levels on it, adjustments, sight glass through here and through here. So not quite sure what's all there and what's all missing, but it's a neat piece of scientific equipment. And some license plates, some oil pieces. This was another interesting find. This, look at the size of this chopping blade. Now this, again, is new stock, even though it's, you know, it's sat around and the worms have attacked the handle a little bit here. And a piece of the blade is broken out. But this is exactly how they packed them. See, they've wrapped them in this thick straw-like rope. Had paper on it first, and then this thick straw-like rope wrapped all the way around so you wouldn't cut yourself in shipping. Really neat to find things like this. Because it can't be very many of them left, you know. And we've got some ironwork down there, a big waffle maker and a fire back, which I'll just take this, take the camera off to show you. Okay. Nice fire back here. Good size, weighs a ton, so I would not recommend shipping. I think I have that marked pickup only, actually. This here waffle maker is great for anybody that has a wood stove, wants to make some waffles. Just sets right on top of your wood stove, and this part comes right out, of course, so you can turn it over, I guess, so it would swivel in those little hooks. Cast iron, of course. Pretty neat piece. Malls over here. This is a neat lot. Those are the jugs I was telling you about. This one actually is a Dalton, and this is a little Redware. That's one lot there. The two of those. We have some interesting jewelry, most of which is this Thunderbird copper bracelet, and this is by the Bell Trading Post in Arizona. Very well-known Navajo place for selling native wares, the Bell Trading Post. This is an interesting Peruvian rain god. I don't know a whole lot about these, but I do know that the consigner knows what he's talking about. It has had an old leg repair. Very long time ago, this leg has been reattached. But interesting old paint on it. Very cool piece. I love this Hague's advertising bottle with the silver work all over it. Just a really neat bottle, marked on the bottom as well. Triangle shape, you can grab it. What else can we show you here? This is a great little piece of Sevres pottery, a little bisque swan creamer. Absolutely gorgeous gilt interior. That's a thick gilt. It's not just a spray on or anything. I mean, they really did it well. Beautifully marked. We have a pot lid with the pot, which is interesting, but a good old English pot lid. Very collectible, these things. Nice to see them with the bottom. And we've got a couple of coins there. One, a commemorative Hudson Bay coin. But this I wanted to show you. St. Margaret's Radar Squadron. This is actually a Zippo, Mark Zippo, with a file and a knife blade, and it just clips onto a belt. But this is actually, like we did a video on lighters, saying about the Zippos, so you want to see that they're actually etched right in. They're not just something stuck on the surface, and that's what this is for the Radar Squadron. And we have... down here we have a lot that's we're calling a gentleman's lot, which has a lot of really neat things. Little watch ring, a bulldog, a razor, a flask. We have some nice turquoise jewelry here, a whole set.
We have a couple of nice sterling pieces here in a lot with the bracelet and the brooch. But what we do have is this absolutely wonderful German fish set. Now, this is a fish slice with the large fork, and you can see the size of these. And these are all 800 silver, German marked 800 silver. Every single piece is marked. So you have a set of 12 forks, 12 knives, and the fish slice and the large fork. And then in a following lot, there is 12 more forks and 12 butter knives, basically, with the 800 silver handle. Now, these are fun. There's a set of these, and these are swizzle sticks. 835, I think these ones are. Don't quote me on that, but they're definitely silver. And of course, you can sip right through them like a straw, but that's to stir up your drink. And I think that's it for what we have over here. The last thing I wanted to show you was this Parker Brothers Across the Continent game. So this is the original lid from the box. And this is actually the instructions on the back of how to play. The rest of the box is long gone. Good early game, but the game board is fantastic. This should actually be framed. I'm gonna try and, when I'm finished talking here, I'm gonna do a little close-up of some of the graphics on this, because there's everything going on all across America here. There's you know, miners and chuck wagons and natives and all sorts of fantastic things. So thanks for watching, folks. I hope that helps you with some of the sizes of the items that we have in the sale. And that's at www.harrisandsonsauctions.com. You can find the link to our high bid, or you can just search high bid for Harris and Sons Auctions. That's the platform. And it is a soft close staggered auction. So that means it will come off, not like eBay where it just ends, but if anybody bids within the last minute, then it extends that item for 3 more minutes. So you can bid your maximum bid and walk away if you like, and it will only take what it needs to put you in the lead. So if you put in 500 and it's asking for 50, it's only going to take 50 until it needs to take more. So you don't have to worry about that. If you have any questions, give us a shout. You can either call us or send us an email. We don't mind answering all the questions that you may have. And if anybody is local and really wants to view something personally, just give us a call, and we're happy to accommodate when we can. We ship worldwide with some exceptions, and of course anything that's marked for Canada only is because of ivory or other restrictions, firearms, that sort of thing. So, and we do have offer safe pickup. So thanks very much again, folks. God bless. I hope that helps you out and that you get a chance to view some of our items. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.